So we got acceleration is equal to minus EE by m. Now we know that acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time, or velocity by time. From this we can write velocity is equal to acceleration into time. Which velocity acquired by the electrons in this case? Nothing but the drift velocity. Therefore, drift velocity is equal to acceleration into time. So, the symbol of the drift velocity is Vd, acceleration A, time is relaxation time. So, we know that A is equal to minus EE by M into tau. So, this 4 it is minus EE by M into tau. By this expression, Vd, drift velocity, is equal to charge of electron into applied electric field by mass of electron into relaxation time. So from this expression we can say that drift velocity is directly proportional to the applied electric field, but in opposite direction. Drift velocity is inversely proportional to the mass of the electron. Drift velocity of the electron is directly proportional to the relaxation time. And drift velocity is directly proportional to the charge of the electron. Because this charge of electron is constant, so that's why this may not be an important assumption by this calculation, but these three are the important calculations. So like this we can define the relationship between electric field and drift velocity, and they both are proportional to each other but in opposite direction. The next concept is relation between electric current and drift velocity. Same assumption we are taking to follow this. A conductor was taken. Its length is L. A is area of cross section. The electric field which is applied across its ends is E. But we can say that relation between electric current and drift velocity. Current is nothing but the number of electrons flowing through a conductor. It is not a single electron, or it is not a single force. That means we should consider some finite number of electrons which are traveling through the conductor to reach the positive terminal. Let us say n is the number of conducting electrons in the medium. Number of electrons through the conductor. So in this case, each electron is moving with velocity Vd to reach the positive terminal. Therefore, Vd is the drift velocity of the electron. The relaxation time is equal to tau. And m is equal to mass, or me is equal to mass of the electron. So if we see the physical quantities that were present in this conducting medium is, let us take a conductor of length L and area of cross section A, and it contains n number of electrons in it which were crossing through it per unit time tau or delta t having mass me and with drift velocity vd. So the total current, passing through the conductor I is equal to Q by T, where the T is time taken. So what is this I? How will you get? What is Q? Charge carriers with velocity Vd with the area of cross section A passing through length L. Therefore, I is equal to number of electrons into charge of each electron into area of cross section which is traveling into its drift velocity. I is equal to N E A Vd. Therefore, I is equal to N E A. What is this Vd? Drift velocity. E E by M into tau. So it is N E square A E by M into tau. So this is the equation we got for electric field. From this, we will find out the electron mobility, resistivity, conductivity, and many more equations. The next concept is electron mobility. So what is this electron mobility? Suppose a conductor is there and we have applied some electric field E across it. Whenever we have applied a unit electric field, and the electrons which were inside the conductor will acquire some drift velocity. And to increase the drift velocity, we should increase the electric field because we know that they both are in the proportionality ratio. So what we can say that the drift velocity acquired by the electrons whenever a unit electric field is applied is called the electron's mobility. The drift velocity acquired by the electron under the applied unit electric field is called electron mobility. The symbol of the electron mobility is mu E. So mu E is equal to drift velocity by electric field. So therefore, the symbol of the drift velocity is Vd. Electric field is E. So what is its SI unit? Velocity by electric field. So therefore, velocity is meter per second. Whatever it is, drift velocity or any velocity, it is in meters per second. Electric field is volt per meter. So it is meter per second into meter per voltage. So therefore, meter square per second volt. Or we can write meter square second inverse volt inverse. So this is the one of the SI unit of electron mobility. Why I am saying one of the? Because electric field has two units. One is volt per meter, another one is Newton per Coulomb. Therefore, another one also it will be written like this. Meter per second by Newton per Coulomb. Therefore, M by S into Coulomb by N. Therefore, meter Coulomb per second, Newton second. So, like this also, we can define the electric mobility or electron mobility. Now we will convert this electron mobility to the other terms of the known physical quantities in the current electricity. So electron mobility mu e is equal to vd by e. This is the standard equation. We know that Vd is equal to Ee by m into tau. So I am substituting that Vd value here. Ee by m into tau whole divided by E. Now we can write this one Ee by m into tau whole divided by E is equal to mu E. This E and E gets cancelled. Therefore it is E tau by m. This is the standard expression for the electron mobility. Electron mobility is directly proportional to the charge of electron, directly proportional to the relaxation time, but inversely proportional to the mass of the electron. We can say that mobility means ability to move. So if mass increases, its motion and ability to move is decreases, which is nothing but the inertia of the electron. So here also the fundamental laws of the physics, which was nothing but the mechanical laws, are valid to understand the current electricity concept. Now we are converting this current also in terms of the electron mobility. So we know that mu e is equal to Vd by e. From this we can write Vd is equal to mu e into e. We know that I is equal to NEA VD. So therefore, NEA, what is VD? Mu E. Therefore, it is NEA mu E. It is the relationship between electric current and electron mobility. So like this, we can find out the equations which are well known in the current electricity chapter.